there, you two. I'm here today to talk to someone who has become a friend and a wonderful student. Jennifer is Nikki, and we're here today to talk about her dog, Nugget. And if anyone knows anything about Nugget, he is one unique individual who's come a long way. And in this interview, you're gonna learn so many things about Nugget. It's a bit of a journey, and we took 5 years and we condensed him into like maybe 45 minutes or so. It's wonderful. You're gonna learn things about what tips Jennifer would recommend to those starting on a journey working with a fearful dog. You might need these, you might need some tissues. It's one of those things, you might need a tissue, so I'll warn you ahead of time. We're also gonna talk about what started her out down this journey. You know, what things brought her to this point. Hiring a professional is not always an easy thing, and we're gonna learn lots today. So stay tuned, because we're gonna interview Jennifer Isnicki about her dog, Nugget. Jen, I wanted to sit down with you and talk a little bit about your experience with living with a fearful dog.
Okay.
And specifically talking about Nugget, mm-hmm. and where this all began, because okay. what we discovered once we decided to sit down is that it's been just about 5 years
yes.
that this journey has started.
It has.
And when I think back to when we first met, it's fascinating and unbelievable at the same time where we're at today with Nugget, and also with your learning as well, because we also train humans,
yes.
right? And so I wanted to sit down and ask you some specific questions, and I know you were kind enough to spend the time and make some notes as well, so you wouldn't forget anything, because it has been a journey.
Super important stuff.
Because I want to help other people like you in your situation who maybe feel like it's a challenge. It's not possible. And to have another person who's been through it and who's not a dog trainer, but who has taken on information to help all of their animals, not just Nugget specifically.
Right.
And so my first question to you is, how did this wonderful dog, who you now call Nugget,
okay.
how did he come into your life and your husband's life?
Okay, we had a dog already. All of our dogs are rescue dogs. And with wonderful, wonderful stories came into our lives. We had Angus already, so Angus was rescued in February of 2010, and Nugget came into our lives. He was found stray in our street back in October of 2010. So it'll be 7 years that we've had, almost 7 years that we've had Nugget.
Oh, wow, okay.
You know, quick little recap of how Nugget came into the Isnicki household was Pete said he saw a little dog outside, and I did not want to go outside. I was very happy with one dog. Who am I?
Because weren't you a cat person before? Would you
very
consider
much,
yourself a cat person?
Yes, very much a cat person. I grew up with animals, dogs and cats, but primarily cats from as small as I can remember. And Pete and I had a mutual dog together named Freddie, and he passed before we moved to Georgia about 11 years ago. And I always wanted another dog. Well, ironically, Angus came into the picture, and he's got his own, we'll do an own video on Nugget. But here comes Nugget, and I had said, no, I don't want to go outside and see this dog. I'm very happy with Angus. And the second day, Pete says, that little dog is outside again. And 2 weeks prior, my mom was trying to rescue a dog out in her neighborhood, and I said, you know, you should name that dog Nugget. So I already had like a Nugget name in my head.
That's kind of funny.
So I went outside, and this dog was literally, he was a puppy. I didn't know what he was. I still don't know exactly what he is. He's a Chihuahua or something. He was literally like curled, like he had his body like folded in half. And I was like, all right, buddy, come on. So I've got pictures from the first day that, you know, Nugget came into the picture. And so we had Angus and Nugget for a good 2 years, solid 2 years, and they still are to this day the best of buds. Never an issue, never an argument, never any altercations, until I adopted Katie.
And then Katie enters the picture.
And then our journey begins, you know. So our journey begins.
I'm gonna pause sure. you for a moment. So you have Angus and you have Nugget.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time, like, was everything just hunky-dory? Like, things going good? No, issues never between had them, or Nugget and other people, or environmental things?
So maybe, I mean, looking back, I mean, maybe there was, but because I was, you know, with both of us out of the house, some like, you know, 8 hours a day, I could leave them alone. Nugget would mark, but I just assumed that was just something, you know, because we were out all day, but I didn't have to crate either one of them. They were fine in the one room together. But looking back, yeah, there were signs, but I didn't know any better. I didn't know, like, him chewing on the windowsill was maybe an anxiety issue, you know, separation anxiety or whatever it might be. Him peeing on things might have been an issue. But him and Angus together was never an issue. It was like, you know.
Right, things were good.
Things were good. So right? I never thought of it. And then, you know, looking back, I did board them a couple times. And, you know, my mentality now is I will never do that again because of what I know now and because of Nugget's, you know, needs. Mm-hmm. So.
All right, so now we're back to Katie. So Katie shows up on the scene. She has her own story. Like, you know, we'll have to have, like, episodes on her. But
yeah.
So
all my dogs and their own little show.
So she shows up.
So I adopt Katie, I bring Katie home with no plan. Again, I'm not very versed on a lot of, you know, dog training stuff because I had such great experience, what I thought, with Angus and Nugget, best buds, right? So I bring Katie home and I'm gonna be honest with you, all hell broke loose.
and what does that look like?
That looks like two big dogs going at it. That looks like a little dog barking his head off. That looks like mom doesn't know what to do, doesn't know how to do it. I didn't have a plan because I didn't know what the plan. I just didn't have a plan because I didn't know how to plan.
And did that start like immediately as she entered your life? Okay.
Yes, and you know, not having you guys in my life at that time, you know, I was taking advice from people in rescue and stuff and how to do introductions and stuff. And I was like, all right, I can do that. I can introduce this dog to my guys and do it outside in the driveway and take them for little walks and reward and stuff like that, but I'm not getting it all, you know, I'm not comprehending it all, you know.
Right. You're going through the motions, don't understand all the behavior side and what they're saying to each other, maybe.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, so we had some fights. We had some fights between the two big guys, Angus and Katie, and my assumption, of course, I'm assuming all these things, again, without having the proper tools and knowledge, is that, you know, she was doing it because I rescued her, and I was coming up with all these things in my own head.
Right, the stories we make up, right?
Exactly, the justifications of why this dog is acting this way, right. And taking advice from people that, you know, were trying to help, because they're not in the situation, but looking in, they're trying to help the best they can.
Sure.
So I did reach out to somebody that our vet at the time recommended, again, not knowing what positive reinforcement was, not knowing the terminology, just needed some help, brought somebody into our home, and I didn't have the warm and fuzzies, it didn't, you know, sit right with me. So somebody that was in, that actually helped with Katie's, you know, getting Katie to me and in the rescue world, recommended Canine Country Academy, and I was desperate because I just didn't feel there was a safe environment for us and for the dogs.
Lots of stress for the humans. It's
big time stress. And I just didn't know. So what do? You reach out for help. So I waved
that white flag.
I did. I mean, I even, like, you know, Facebook is awesome. It gives you like the reminders of, like, you know, from years past and, you know, any recommendations of a dog. And I still have those come up in my news feed.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just don't put them up there now because I got the tools. But somebody mentioned Canine Country, and they specifically said Kathy, and I called Kathy, and, you know, she asks me, you know, she did like a pre-screening, I remember, and she, at that point, I guess whatever I had told her, I don't know what I said exactly verbatim, probably just pleading for help.
Right, like, I'm overwhelmed.
And,
when can you get here?
She came, and Pete was... It must have been after work because we were home already, and she came and she spent a good hour and a half, maybe 2 hours with us, and she just said, just show me, you know, kind of like, let me see what's going on. And I really thought that it was bringing Katie into the house that disturbed, you know, the equilibrium, so to speak, and the universe that was going on. It was Katie.
Right.
Okay.
She's the problem.
She's the problem.
Gotta fix her.
What have I done? All I wanted to do was save her life, you know, and so I'm like, you know, going through all these things in my head. And so Nugget goes outside, and Nugget goes right to the fence. and Nugget starts barking. Now, at the time, I don't think my neighbors had their dogs, but he just had this routine of going to the fence and barking. And there was actually like a path, you know, from Nugget just screaming down, you know, the grassy area, because that's just what Nugget did. And Nugget would just bark, 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 bark. So anyway, you know, long story short, she says, it's not her, it's your little guy. And I'm like, oh my God, what do you mean? They've been, so, you know.
He's been wonderful until we got this dog.
Everything was fine until she came in the picture. And I love Katie to death. You know, I love all my guys to death. So she, you know, fast forward, she spent a lot of time with us and, you know, taking notes. And she says, this is what I recommend. And at the time it was called, I think we all called it nose work. Mm-hmm. And explain, please, Kathy. And she says, well, you know, and she went through the whole, you know, notion, you know, explaining what nose work was. And in the back of my head, I said, this was a bunch of crap.
Well, it was very new. I mean, honestly, like even today, people have a better idea of what it is. But back then, it was brand new to Georgia. Mm-hmm. It had only, you know, been around maybe 6-7 years total by then, right? And so, like, people didn't know what it was.
Right.
And then it's not like many people think obedience, right? Like, my dog needs manners, they need self-control, and those things are helpful. But now we're putting like a totally foreign thing and being like, yeah, let's have your dog sniff around, right? And you're like,
well, it's like self-control. Like, I didn't even know, like, if the dog could sit, stay, you know, wait at the door, don't, you know, I just thought basic things was all a dog should be doing, mm-hmm. you know, not realizing that the dog has so much more to offer, you know.
Right.
So, you know, not in the back of my head, you know, the glass half full, being optimistic, pessimistic type of thing. I was like, all right, Jennifer, you've called somebody here. You just, you know, you're paying money for this. She's a professional. She's got an awesome background. She owns this business. Trust it. So we signed up for class and, you know, not knowing what to expect, I guess.
Right.
So Nugget's turn comes up and, you know, his reactivity is lunging at people. So I was scared, but I was very, you know, I was instructed to say, you know, the dog stays in the car. I mean, there was this whole process of the safety issue mm-hmm. before the dog enters the door that I think when we start class, you know, the people are taught first. And then we go one by one and everything is broken up and everybody's safe on one side and you potty over here and you do this over there and, you know, watch out for each other and, mm-hmm. you know, respect each other's space and all this stuff. So I'm taking this all in because I didn't know any of this stuff.
Right. Have you ever taken a dog class?
No.
Right.
No.
Yeah. And here we're putting you in something that's new and different.
Yeah. So I'm getting like sucker punched all over, you know, like and bolted with all this information. So, you know, I've got to hold my stuff together and process, and then I've got to be careful, you know, of his safety and stuff like that. I'm like, oh my God, this is really serious stuff. So, you know, his things are like lunging, barking is huge for him, bolting if he's scared, like, that's something we can talk about later. But, you know, those are the three primary things that Nugget reacts to. You know, is when
he's... That's how he, like, when he's nervous.
When he's nervous or scared, not confident.
Right.
This is what he does.
He's gonna lash out, if you will.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, and for a little dude, he's very loud.
He's ferocious.
He's ferocious.
And how did he feel looking back? You know, I remember what he was like, but, you know, did he come in the room and look at everybody like, what are you doing here?
Yes. And what are you doing here?
Going on? And did he vocalize
yes.
then?
Yeah, he was very vocal. Very vocal. Like, if you're not in Nugget's world today, you know, you can earn your way into Nugget's world.
Which is shocking, right?
Yes. And now that he's taken so many classes, you know, he can look at the peanut gallery, we
uh-huh.
call it.
Yeah.
And he's like, oh, it's just you. Oh, it's just you. You know,
right.
You weren't here last week, you know.
Right. But I'll give you a chance.
But
right?
I'll give you a chance because, you know, I'm Nugget now. And,
yeah. Right. King Nugget.
But, you know, so I saw that the process was working, and I went home and told Pito, you know, this is pretty amazing stuff, you know, first class and stuff. And
so the first class you saw a bit of a shift.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
He's a little more focused.
And I'm not just saying any of this stuff. This is, you know, this is true. Like,
right.
You know, yeah. I've done years of this and multiple rounds, and I don't think I could ever not do enough of it. I do it at home because it's such a confidence builder. again, I think we agree that we're not going to change who Nugget is, just like we're not going to change who we are.
Right.
But we can change the way that he reacts to environment.
Or coping skills, right?
Exactly.
It's like anger management.
Correct.
Right? In a way,
we can lessen the blow.
Right. We give him more tools and you more tools to set him up for success
right. And
be his advocate for him. And what I'll tell you guys is that what I remember about Nugget, aside from his reactivity in the classroom, is that he was able to kind of get it together and work.
Mm-hmm.
He was still able to search out his food at the time, and other dogs search for toys.
Mm-hmm.
But what was really interesting, and I think you were really open at the time to this, and that's what helped, is his first 6 weeks, they were good. They were good,
mm-hmm.
right? Saw improvement. And then, you know, maybe week six, you know, you were like, well, what do I do now?
Right.
What's the next thing I do now? And there was something about him, and I can't always explain how I feel about things because I'm just reading him and reading how things are going. I said, let's do another round of level one. So level one is just boxes, right? Let's do another round of level one. And it was literally the next week, so it was like week seven for him. She didn't miss a class.
Nope.
And he came in, and he was like a different dog.
Yes, yes.
It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And I see this over and over and over again, and I hope it never stops amazing me.
Mm-hmm.
He was different. And even you were like, is this the same dog?
Is this my dog?
He was so, like, cool. He wasn't cool with me, but he was, like, cool.
Yeah.
It's like, I'm here to do my gig. He didn't know it was another round, right? He didn't sign up for the registration.
Right.
But he just came in and said, like, I'm doing this now,
mm-hmm.
and I can be bothered with all the other stuff. He might have still been edgy.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't have the reaction.
Well, what was good also is that you were very complimentary to his, you know, sensitive ears, which is part of the issue, too. And, like, you know, instead of, and all, and everybody, even, you know, all the girls, you know, that worked with Nugget, and everybody's pretty much worked with him, has been very respectful, like, not to maybe throw a box in the beginning.
Right.
You know, maybe not to maybe, like, move your foot too quickly, because he would react to that. Now, I'm not saying.
You can't giggle or talk under your breath.
Right. He would, right away.
What are you doing?
Yeah. Yeah.
He's intense.
He is very intense. But, so that helped, too. It was, like, you know, respecting him also
mm-hmm.
and his, you know, I just call him Nuggetisms.
Right.
You know, because every dog that reacts has their own thing.
Right.
You know, that's a good question.
Yeah.
Because when Kathy said I would recommend putting him in scent work, or at the time maybe you just called it nose work,
mm-hmm.
and she elaborated on what that was, in the back of my head I was very doubtful, but I had a professional at my house that I was paying money for, so part of me had to trust the process,
mm-hmm.
so I signed up for a class and saw that the dog sticking his head in the box and him going back to the box because he was getting rewarded, like right there was improvement.
Right, because he would put his head in the box.
And then he would continue, even though you could tell like there was that scarcity still in him, the way he was positioning his body, which later I was able to read, you know, body language of a dog, you know, because I continued my education, but watching him still doing it because he knows there was a reward. So he was being rewarded for the behavior
mm-hmm.
and continued to do it. So, you know, from the first class, there was definite improvement. So, you know, I thought, why not continue?
Right. So any inch of improvement
absolutely
was worth seeing what would happen next.
Absolutely. And for me, it was a totally new world because I didn't know what positive reinforcement was, because, you know, we always say that, you know, when I was a kid, you know, this is how we did things,
right?
You know, but it's really, you know, things change and methods change, and there's different ways to get the same result in a more positive manner. So this was the way to go, and ever since then Nugget has improved with his Nuggetisms and his, you know, he's a very smart dog, he's capable of so much, just like all of them are. But it's what we allow them to be. We have to let them be who they are, whether they're scared, confident. They just need guidance.
Right, they need tools, right?
They need tools.
Because sometimes they can't achieve it, or an individual can't achieve it on their own.
Correct.
Right, right. So Jen, you know, you started with nose work, and I want to fast forward and kind of lump it all together.
Mm-hmm.
If you could list, best to your knowledge, all the things you've done with this dog in the last 5 years that have contributed to who he is today?
Wow. Okay, so...
It's a tall order, I know.
Well, you know, 5 years we've done, you know, so many rounds of nose work, which we call scent work now. Mm-hmm. We've done some other classes in it. We've done reactive agility. We've done other classes. I can't really remember.
Okay, I'll do the classes, you do the seminars. Okay. So you've done nose work consistently. Over time, and obviously you've gotten your other dogs involved.
Absolutely.
Not neglected them by any means.
No, ma'am.
But Nugget was, you know, the primary concern. So you did nose work multiple times, took some breaks. We got to level two. So level two is when you start working outside in other environments. And we waited until he was confident enough to handle that because there's no point in rushing.
Right.
So we did that. Then we did the primary reactive class, you know, teaching him more coping skills.
Right.
So scent work was build that confidence up because he didn't really have enough to get into reactive, or we weren't offering it at the time. Then reactive class. Then we did some modules with reactive class, like reactive agility and Nugget getting on surfaces. That's hard.
Yes.
It's noisy. It's weird. It's very tactile sensitive.
Right.
So that was amazing. And we even had a photographer come in and take pictures of him.
Yeah,
which was big time. It was someone who, you know, knew him, but still.
Right. But we had somebody with a camera, you know.
In his space.
In his space.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, huge success.
Yep.
That was fun.
So he did a couple of those things. We've done some private lessons.
Yes.
We've done day training. And, you know, this may sound like a lot, and it is. And, you know, let's not calculate how much it costs. but all of those things pieced together over time, right, and you continued things at home,
right,
helped. So each thing was just another step in his story.
Right.
And then what are some extra things you did, and if you can remember, like kind of what order you did things,
because
you were kind of conservative when it came to bringing him to certain events.
Well, conservative for him, and then because I have the other four, you know, and I was in between, you know, Nugget doing stuff.
By the way, she said four. Other four.
Four. I have five. you know, like we were joking, you know, I never neglected the other ones, you know, so between day training, which was awesome, classes with the other four dogs, and pop-in events, like there was other events too that the other guys were involved with. But back in 2014, we had a seminar here, and I was nervous as anything. I picked a working spot, and it was the T-Touch seminar. And I stressed it to the second I walked in and set up his little pod and put blankets over it, if he was going to be okay, if I was going to be okay, number one, and
right,
you know, he was going to be okay.
Because the setup was,
oh.
Right? So how many dogs?
There was 10 dogs, I believe.
Right? And what are all of their challenges?
They react.
They react, right? They were fearful in some
so
way.
So picture 10, yeah, exactly, 10.
In a 4,000 square foot space.
Yeah, yeah. But the good thing was, you know, for as many dogs that you knew were coming, you knew how to, you know, space them properly. So I had, God forbid, I needed an out, I had an out, which was cool.
Right. And it was designed for that.
Yeah, exactly. So that was, I mean, that was nerve-wracking, but, you know, Kathy, you know, Cascade was phenomenal at what she does, and so we went through, that was a 3-day actually, because we did something that Friday with
other animals.
Mm-hmm. That was kind of fun.
And you just like got dipped into T-Touch, right? We did wraps on him. Wraps on the humans, we had human interaction. We did ground work.
Yeah.
We did confidence course. We did a lot with him.
Yes.
And then, how many years later, did you do a second one with him? Because I know you did one with
Brody because Brody's reactivity is different than Nugget. So that was a totally, that's, again, Nugget. Brody needs his own video. So I went back and we did it 2 years later.
Okay.
And, you know, I toyed with the idea, you know, and I said, you know what, it can't hurt. Because I thought of it this way. Even though it was my third time doing it, I know because the first time I got a lot of information, and I got a lot of information for Brody when I did it, but because I was so focused on his safety at the time and very nervous, that I got more information the third time. So it just, everything I've done is added to my own toolbox.
Right.
So it's just been a beneficial addition.
In addition to your learning, you're building confidence in your skills.
Oh, yeah.
And your knowledge and how to handle, a nugget dog.
Right.
And that was in a different location.
Yes.
As well.
It was challenging because there was noise, there was wind. He doesn't like that kind of stuff, with the sensitivity to his ears. And he did bark and he did, and then, unfortunately somebody stared at him at the seminar and he, I'm going to use the wrong term, but he turned on, the other end of the leash.
Right.
So.
Like redirected.
He redirected. That was the word I was looking for. And it was just fault of somebody staring at him. Hey, we never stare at dogs.
Right.
It's creepy. And especially in a reactive environment.
Totally.
But yes, it's given me more tools in my toolbox. Every time I go to a seminar, every book I read, every YouTube video I watch, every, either seminar or a drop-in class that we do with any of the dogs, it's just more tools how to handle a situation.
Right, you became like a student of Nugget. Right? And then each of them have their own.
Each of, yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Cool. Awesome. So, that leads me into, I'm going to get into a couple other things too, but if you had to pause here today after 5 years of knowledge and really getting into things, what are three things that you would tell someone, you would tell the Jennifer is Nikki from 5 years ago? What would you tell her to tell her, like, it's going to be okay? We don't know where Nugget was going, right? Like, he was making improvement. There's no guarantees in this, right? Because it's behavior. I can't guarantee my behavior nor yours.
Right, right.
But if you had to give people three insights or three tips if they were starting down this journey or even considering working with their dog who has some fearful issues, and what I want to point out to these people that you would be talking to is Nugget is not a reactive dog.
Right. No,
right?
He's not a reactive dog.
Because a large percentage of his life, 95 if not more percent of the time, around his house, in his own world, and in places he feels safe, he's great.
Yes.
He's wonderful.
He is, yeah.
Right? He and I have become dear friends, and I value his relationship more than I would another dog who takes me in right away, right? Because I earned that relationship, and it amazes me to this day thinking about where we came from, and so I always think that when I meet someone who's in that situation. But those people who are struggling and thinking and considering the costs and all those things, what three things would you say?
That's a great question.
It's a big one. It's a whopper.
First, find support. Find your tribe, I call it, and just take in as much information. Please be open-minded. Take in as much information as you can, and don't think of things, when things are of a value to you, don't think of them as having an expensive or a high cost, because the outcome of the work that you put in outweighs the cost of what you dish out. So, I never thought of it, sometimes, I would have to space them out, because I have five, but I would have to space them out, yes, because there was so much I did want to do and so much progress I wanted, but I didn't want to rush it. So, I had to, space it out a little bit.
And prioritize, right? Like,
exactly.
This is what this
exactly.
one needs now.
Correct. That's why he was a priority for so long, and I didn't want to, leave everybody else out. So that's why they were incorporated. And yes, we did take breaks from here and there. We're on a break right now for a couple of reasons. But, so find your support,
and your tribe.
Find your tribe.
Your dog training tribe.
That's right, that's right. Educate yourself. So it's not just come to class, go home, maybe do the homework. Because your dog's going to tell you when they come back to class if you've done the homework or not. So there's
right.
no lying.
They tell on you.
They tell.
Right? So number two, get educated.
Educated, yeah. And then you're going to find that you're going to, hopefully, that you're going to want to read a book, and you're going to want to ask more questions, and you're going to want to do other things, because the things that you're able to do today is because of what you've done yesterday and the day before and years ago. You build it up, right? And don't rush the process. You have to have patience. And I'm going to give you more than three.
Oh, whoa, okay, bonus!
Patience was another one, too. I didn't know exactly what to say, but patience is definitely one of them.
Patience is huge. With not just the dog. right?
Oh, yeah. I've learned to be a very patient person. Some people might challenge that, but, you know, you're forced to be patient if this is what you really want, you know, and I'm going to be honest with you, there would have been no way to have rescued two more after Nugget, you know, and it'd be fair, even though it was, you know, some people might say otherwise, you know, sometimes, you know, my vulnerable heart, I had to rescue Gracie and Brody, but that was challenging for Nugget too. But because I've done a lot of the groundwork, you know, I knew I had support, I learned how to be patient, and I was partially educated, you know. The other thing is don't give up.
Right, so number four, don't give up. So even if those first three things don't do you well,
yeah,
right, don't give up.
Don't give up.
Sorry, guys, get the tissues. I should have warned you. I should have warned you. Because it's really hard, right? Like, this isn't easy. It's not an easy process.
Well, you got to think about it, too. You know, would you want somebody to give up on you? You know, and you might be doing your best. And, you know, what if somebody gave up on you? It would make you feel terrible. And then you go back to square one, you know, or you just... Who knows what happens?
Well,
know?
I think that happens a lot in society because we're an instant fix. We're a get it done. You know,
right.
take that 160 class, miracle, right? This pill, take this thing, right? And when you're dealing with any kind of behavior, especially with fear.
Right.
Especially with fear.
Well, we know how it is when we're scared, you know, and then, you know.
Just get over it, it's fine,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Or just go put yourself in a situation again, you know, desensitize yourself, you know, yourself or whatever, but that's a whole other topic.
But, don't give up in the process.
Don't give up in the process because you didn't see, you know, immediate results in 6 weeks. Because if you really pay attention to detail, you're going to see it. That's why you have to come into your class with an open mind. You know, set yourself and your dog up for success from day one with that open mind that, you know, just because Nuggets had slight changes in the beginning and your dog didn't, doesn't mean that it's not going to work. You know, some dogs come in and I've watched it because I've been a student for so long, they shut down, but at the end of week six, I'm looking at the owner and I'm like, your dog just did amazing.
Right.
You know.
And that's the thing, I think you find a lot of support in any kind of class that's dealing with fear.
Right.
So nose work, we all become a team, they're all our dogs, same in reactive class. And, you know, would you say you ever had a day that you kind of lost hope?
No, there might have been a day where I'm like, what happened? And then looking back on my day, you know, you would ask me or I would say, you know, say to myself, well, you know what, maybe I talked too loud to Pete. Maybe it was me that set him off. Maybe it was a thunderstorm from last night. Maybe it was, you know, we almost crashed the car coming here because a jerk cut us off. You know, you just never know,
right?
You know.
So you took a step back. So any time that maybe you would have, I don't know, maybe this is a bad day, you would have said, well, what? Let me take a step back.
Right.
What's going on?
Right.
What's really the cause of this?
Right.
It doesn't mean that all of my investment and time and money just went down the toilet.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You just stayed the course.
Absolutely.
And I think that's really hard. I think that's unique about you and Team Nugget because not everybody can do that. Right?
Yeah.
Right.
And I get upset because I'm like, you know, just please give it time, you know. So don't give up. You know, they have insecurities just like us. And at the end of the day, you know, you could be their lifesaver, you know, because, you know, I honestly feel that, you know, why did you take in this dog if you weren't going to put in the work, you know, and
it's just like any relationship, right?
Exactly. You know, you do a lot of compromising. Believe me, we've done a lot of compromising over the years, you know, just for their own safety. And I give up certain luxuries and I give up certain things. You know, I'm not saying everybody should do this, but because of the tribe that I have and the clan I have, because at the end of the day, they're good dogs, they're loving dogs, you know, they have a lot to offer, they just need jobs, and just like us, you know, we are not confident in every single thing that we run into every single day, so
it's a really good point.
I always say that they're no different than us in a lot of ways, they just need that guidance,
right,
you know, and they're looking for things, they're always offering us something, some behavior, it's just, you know, the other thing I wanted to mention is, you know, we're asking them to live in our worlds. You know, we need to live more in their worlds, you know, for them to be the dog that we want them to be, you know.
And to really see the world from
their perspective. Mm-hmm. I truly believe that, and I will take that to my grave. And then, you know, you know, like you had said, you know, Nugget Circle, you know, I think he's more inviting, you know, to people now. Just if you know, you approach him just with some respect, you're in Nugget Circle. I found that with Hannah the other day when she came to the car and she asked, you know, it's just respecting the dog, you know, may I give Nugget a treat? Sure. Was I dying inside a little bit? Absolutely. You know, but I knew Hannah would gently go to Nugget. I knew she would do this and I knew this. I already knew what Hannah was going to do, but if it was a stranger, I would say no. You know,
right.
You know, I don't want him to do something that, you know, might not be acceptable.
Right. You know. Absolutely. So let me summarize, Jen, the 3/ bonus to things you shared. If Jen was going to share 5 tips to someone who's in her position from 5 years ago, who's maybe starting on the journey or considering working with their fearful dog, the 5 tips that she would share is, number 1, find your tribe, find your support, because that's going to make all the difference in the world. Number 2 is educate through coming to training, reading the books that are recommended, going to seminars, YouTube videos, you know, all the wonderful information that's out there today. Number 3 is really good, patience. We all can benefit from that. So to have patience with our dog, with ourselves, with the process. Number 4, our first bonus, is to really never give up. Never give up in the process, because it is a process. And then number 5, kind of a doozy, is to see the world from the dog's perspective, really setting them up for success, giving them a job, seeing what's in their world, and how we can make some compromises and adjustments in our life to have them in our lives and be happy and healthy, right? So those are the 5 things that she would share, and I think those are so valuable, coming from someone who's been through this process, mm-hmm. right? So I want to thank you so much spending this time. I know it's been a journey, and we could probably talk for much longer. I might have to do follow-up in five more years, right?
Every day is a journey. You know, every day is there's something.
There is something. I've been happy to, and I know everyone on the team at Canine Country Academy has enjoyed the process, because we also become very attached to these dogs and people as well.
Yes.
Because our job is to be part of the relationship. You know, when we enjoy that, that's why we do what we do. Mm-hmm. Not for the Benjamins, but thinking about all these things and the process you've come through, mm-hmm. thinking about maybe the last 6 months to a year, what are some takeaways that you're really, like these nuggets of nugget, that you're really holding on to and that are very valuable that you'd like to finish our wonderful interview off with?
2 words, the connection that that Nugget and I have, and the trust.
And then what has that led you to, that connection and trust that you guys have?
It's on YouTube.
We'll make sure to link it in the comments down below.
My dog that reacts to people and noise passed his ORT, you know, his odor recognition test, in March 18th, by the way. And that's a huge accomplishment for Team Nugget. You know, I advocated on social media because Mama was nervous.
He passed it his first time,
but without that connection and trust and the process and all the work that the both of us put in, it's not just me. I mean, Nugget did the work. You know,
right.
I just brought him here.
He found the box, right?
And, you know, it was just the biggest accomplishment, you know, personally, because I attributed to his success. I'm not taking credit, but it was him that did the work. But by me taking my own 5 tips and applying them, that was our huge success story. So I'm just very grateful that we've gotten to this point.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Great job. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you liked it so much and you feel like other people would enjoy it, be sure to hit the share button. And if you're new to our channel and our videos, make sure to hit that red button to subscribe. If you enjoyed this video and have questions regarding living with a fearful dog, post it in the comments down below. Or maybe your dog has accomplished many things from being fearful and having more confidence. We'd love to hear that too. So thanks again for watching, and see us for more interviews at Canine Country Academy.